just now got the feeling that we're meeting for the first time.
Hey, it's Jackson. I'm hanging out with the guys from the script, Mark and Glenn.
Hey,
how's it
Jackson,
going?
How are you?
We're down one man right now.
You're down one man?
Yeah.
So what's going on with Danny?
We've all been coming down a bit of a cold lately, and last night we played Central Park in New York.
Okay, yeah.
I think he pushed a little too much on the vocals, so
yeah.
Just because, you know, we sing with a cold on.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a doctor with him right now checking out, so he's okay, so can barely talk at the moment. So.
Yeah, definitely wanted to do a great show tonight.
I know,
it's the thing, you know, it's maintenance for a singer, so it might need an injection of adrenaline or something to sort out his, it's got kind of a gravelly sound to it, you know.
Do you guys watch American Idol?
Not really.
The last two finalists, Lauren, she had a problem with her vocal cords.
No.
They gave her a shot and she sounded perfect.
It's really funny. You can only get them within close proximity, or not within close proximity to each other, because apparently they're pretty bad for you, so you're supposed to space them.
Yeah. Unless you want to get addicted to it.
Yeah. Just numb the pain, don't they? They just went past that, yeah.
Yeah. So I wanted to ask you guys about the music video for the first time, which features an actress, a famous Rockers actress.
Yeah,
actually.
Eve Houston, Paul Houston's daughter from Bono.
AKA the man himself, Bono of U2.
Now, how did you get here, first time?
We were shooting the video. We had an idea for the video that we wanted to make a mini movie, like a 15-minute mini movie that would go along with our music. We just do a performance and edit all that together. Because the story was so complex to us that we really wanted to expand on it a little bit and have it just online, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
When the script came through for us, we just our director, Charles May Lynn, kind of challenged us. He said, I guess everybody thinks because we're Irish and we're a band, we obviously know U2. We don't really, we've played with them, but we don't really know them, you know.
Right.
I guess he thought, why don't you call up Bono, you're a good friend, and we were like, I don't think Bono would take our call. Well, what we did was we called up a mutual friend and we just said, look, we've a space open for her. She's doing really well acting-wise right now. She's just doing a new movie with Sean Penn. So we figured we'd throw it to her, see what she thought, and she actually loved the band and said she'd love to do it.
Awesome. So you lucked out.
Yeah.
Now, did Bono show up?
No. That was the funny thing. She shot it in New York while we were in London.
Oh, okay.
I haven't actually met the girl yet,
which is funny, yeah.
That's pretty interesting.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. We posted on our Facebook for our fans to ask you guys some questions.
Oh, great.
And one of the questions was, how are you inspired on this last album to write the songs like for the first time?
It was for the first time kind of came about after like a 2-year touring cycle. We were going around, and what happens when you're living on a bus and you're living on the road, it becomes you end up in a slightly little bubble of your own, you know, and it's hard to kind of stay in touch with the real world, so to speak. When we got back to Ireland, the recession had really hit so hard that it was really affecting friends and family of ours and, you know, everything like that. And before that, obviously being musicians ourselves and not having a lot of work, we've been dealing with our own personal recession for a long time, living in people's houses and their sofas and stuff. So we know what that's like, and we went back, we really wanted to celebrate with our friends and family, because they were the ones in the first place that kind of, we would bum off, you know, they would drive us everywhere, get us to rehearsals, things like that. We wanted to say thank you to them and kind of say, we just supported you too, we just supported Paul McCartney kind of thing. But actually, the stark reality hit us that the recession was just kicking their asses, you know.
Yeah.
All the material possessions were being taken away. And we found amongst that there's a silver lining amongst Irish people. Generally, in very bleak times, there's always this element of hope, you know, element of, that, you know, we don't actually need the money, fuck it, let's just come together and, you know, let's drink our bottle, our cheap bottles of wine, let's just eat our dinner off the floor if we have to. And it was just a nice way, although we don't really see it as a recession song. We wrote it about some friends going through the recession.
Mm-hmm.
But I think now people are wearing that as the recession song, you know, it's being played as an anthem, you know, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, everyone loves it.
Mm, yeah, it's really cool.
Another question on Facebook, kind of silly, but people want to know boxes or briefs.
Boxers.
Boxers, yeah, definitely.
Can
boxers.
You? Can
all
you...
of us boxers.
Okay.
Some tidy whities, some not.
I thought you were going to say, can you show us? I was going to go,
no.
Oh.
Virginia, do you want
to? I would have if you want.
We're taping,
may,
we're taping.
Off the camera. Okay.
Yeah, right, right.
The lens not, may not be able to take that.
Going way, well, not way back, but a couple of years ago, you guys have actually been together for a while, but Glenn, you came in kind of
yes,
towards
later
the
on.
End.
Yeah.
Before, you know, informed the script. Can
yeah.
you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. I met Mark in Dublin through some musical friends, and one guy gave me his number and said, you should call this guy, you two have a lot in common. So one day I was sitting at home and I thought, I'll ring this number, and I called him up and we just clicked on the phone, and Mark invited me into town at the James Street, where he had a studio at the back of his mother's house. And I drove in and we sat down and played with some ideas that I'd been working on, some songs I'd worked on, and he was home for about a week and he's like, why don't you come in, we'd write a song together and just have a jam, you know. So I did that and it went really well, and he said, you know what, I'm going back to LA, why don't you come out and visit LA for a week or two, I think you'd really like it out there. So sure enough, I grabbed my bag and I jumped on a plane and I was out there about a few weeks later, and when I got to the airport, Mark took me from the airport straight to the studio, which is where Dan was. And Danny was working on something he was working on for himself. And he'd no drummer on it or anything like that. He'd no other musicians in there with him. And he was like, do you want to try and play on this, you know? And I had Mark met me as a guitar player, but I told him I had studied drums and played drums all my life. So they kind of threw me into the deep end of this studio. It was just like, get up there and play. And there were some other musicians around. And it was kind of, you know, I walked into a room.
Sink or swim.
There's a drum kit and a load of these musicians from LA. And I was like, okay, what am I supposed to do? Get up there and play. So I jumped up and played and I swam. Thank God. And that was it. We wrote our first demo, which was Before the Worst. Mm-hmm. And it was from that then that that's how I got into it. That we became a band around the music, I think, you know. It wasn't like, let's make a band. We were
it's
friends.
It's really been music first for us, you know.
Yeah.
We always say that music is just the thing that always...
So right under our noses, we kind of just formed, and then Mark brought the music off and played to somebody, and they were like, you guys are a great band, how long are you together? And Mark loved it and went out with like 6 or 7 months together, you know.
We weren't really together at all.
A true, a true Irishman, you know, a proper little hustler, you know. So he called me up then, I was back in Dublin at that stage, and he said, listen, these guys think we're fucking amazing, they think we're a band, and I told him we were. And he's like, do you want to do this? And I was like, yeah, let's do it. And honestly, that's exactly how it happened, you know.
We like to say the condom broke in the music industry, the script was born. It was
that's the
accident.
Truth, though. It wasn't like
that's
we,
awesome.
It wasn't like we settled out and masterminded this band. It was not like that at all. If anything, the music brought us together. Mm-hmm. We did, yeah.
Now, being, you know, Irish, there's a little bit of stigma.
Yes,
these
there
guys
is,
are
yeah.
living the rock
really
life.
Tall.
Yeah.
But now that you drink a lot,
yeah.
Are you living the rock star lifestyle?
We have been known to have a tipple or two.
I think we are. I think I've only gotten to grips with it because I'm meeting other bands now that I'm on the road with so many other bands, and they're all like, you boys okay? we tend to.
I thought we were normal until I met the other bands, and then I realized actually we're probably a little bit home.
I think we like to have fun.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
Do you have a favorite beer?
German beer. German beer is always the best.
Okay.
They have a rule in Germany that you're not allowed to put chemicals into the beer.
That's right.
So you don't get a hangover.
Yeah.
So
go through loads of that stuff.
That's always the best.
Wake up okay.
Yeah, have you guys ever had Carlsberg?
Yeah,
that's my favorite.
Oh, yeah.
Carlsberg's not bad. I think it's Danish beer.
Yeah, it's from Denmark.
For me, Guinness, but the Guinness is the one drink that you can't get around the world the same as Dublin, you know?
Really?
Yeah, it's really hard to get a good point outside the world.
I'm really a red wine and a whiskey fan, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
I love whiskey, so.
So, what can people expect from a script show?
I think a lot of energy, a lot of passion. We go out and play every show like it's our last show. We really do.
Okay.
And a lot of honesty, you know, we get out there and we really get behind the songs because we're the creators of them, so to get out there and play that stuff each night is really like opening yourself up again.
Yeah.
And it's great to get out there and really get into them, you know, so I think people will get that, and if the energy is good from the audience and it comes up to us like that, we give it back out even more, and then it just builds up and you end up getting a bit of voodoo in the air, a bit of magic, you know.
It's normally a fucking crazy night. I mean,
yeah.
Even every gig we play, we always hear people that work in the venue say, you know, they don't go that crazy all the time. I mean, they really get involved, really sing along, and I think what they realise is that we're just normal lads that's in a very extraordinary situation.
Mm-hmm.
We don't kind of carry the bravado of the music industry with us, I suppose. We just, we like to just play music and that's it.
Yeah.
And I think they know that about us, so, and it's just, they just get involved straight at the top, you know.
Is there any artist right now that is, you know, that you could say you look up to as doing kind of the same thing you're doing, building that audience that is truly passionate about music?
I think there's a lot out there that, and then sometimes they don't get the credit for it. I think Plan B is a great artist that is really building up his live world really well. Adele, of course, is a fantastic
artist.
Adele,
that's a personal favorite.
Yeah, she's a good friend of ours as well. She's a lovely, lovely girl.
Wait, are you her ex that's trying to sue her?
What?
Her ex is trying to sue her.
No way.
Yeah, for basically the ideology of her latest album. He's saying, you wrote that because of me.
Well, then we're fucked. What woman is going to come
out? You have a lot of girls there.
Uh-oh.
There's going to be a serious amount of
call that lawyer!
We're in trouble.
Oh, no.
That's
what an
awesome.
Idiot.
Well, thank you guys so much for your time.
Thank you.
We appreciate it, and we know you're going to put on a great show tonight.
Thanks
so
very much.
Appreciate it.